Welcome back to the show. Well, as Sydney sweats through a record heat wave, the attention of our fires is in the state's central west, where fires are burning out of control. Let's get an update now from RFS Deputy Commissioner Peter McKechnie. Good morning to you. Nice to see you this morning, Peter. What fire, that fire that was burning at emergency levels is now at watch and act. Can you tell us the areas of concern for you this morning?
Yeah, good morning, Carl. The Alpha Road fire there, which is north of Hill End, right up north of Bathurst there, it did drop back to watch and act overnight after being an emergency warning yesterday. But look, those communities up around Tambaroora, over towards Perimal, they need to be really, really monitoring this fire today. It's not contained. There is a lot of active fire edge up there. And with these strong westerly winds again today, it will challenge firefighters. And again, we'll be getting advice out to the community. But we ask people, please stay up to date. Make sure your properties are prepared. It will be another challenging day.
It looks like the weather might be a helping hand in some parts of the state, but in others, it's still going to be awful.
Yeah, look, whilst today's not quite as bad as it was yesterday, we've still got total fire bans in the Central Ranges, in the Greater Hunter area. And where these fires are burning around at the Alpha Road fire and others up near Wellington and Dubbo, we're still going to see 30, 40 kilometre an hour westerly winds, really warm temperatures and very dry. So again, a few uncontained fires, bad conditions. It is a day that, again, we'll see firefighters really challenged in these areas.
Oh, it was so hot yesterday in some parts of Sydney, especially out west, and those winds were howling, weren't they? I was surprised there weren't more incidents even closer to the big population bases.
Look, we didn't see many near the big population bases, but again, through that central west, we saw lightning over the weekend. We saw lightning again last night in the north of the state. So we saw some 14,500 hectares burnt yesterday.
Wow.
So whilst not on the fringe of Sydney, very challenging.
How's everyone holding up?
Look, obviously people had a long night out there. They're actively defending properties around that Alpha Road fire, but the crews are back out there again today. We're doing changeovers to our day shifts. The aircraft will be back in the air shortly. So we go around again, but it'll take us several days to actually get all these fires contained.
And how's the weather work out for you in the next few days?
Look, challenging today and again into tomorrow. And then we do see an easing condition, so some ideal opportunities to get those containment lines in, try and get these fires contained towards the weekend.
All right, best of luck with it. Everyone does a great job. Thank you for your time this morning. Appreciate it.
Well, turning to a Today weather alert now, a heatwave over New South Wales. We'll see residents sweat through another day of scorching temperatures. The mercury in Sydney will rise above 30 degrees as firefighters continue battling bushfires in the state's west. A blaze north of Bathurst is still burning out of control but is now at a watch and act level. There is a total fire ban in place across the Greater Hunter and Central Ranges. Let's go to Today correspondent Lara Vella, who is live at RFS headquarters for us this morning. Lara, how long will this heatwave last?
Well, Sarah, more milder temperatures will start to kick in from Thursday. But as for today, unfortunately, it is not a good forecast when it comes to the bushfire danger across New South Wales. Once again, scorching temperatures and very, very gusty winds. This morning, Sarah, I wanted to take our viewers inside the State Operations Centre here in Sydney. This is basically the heart of the RFS HQ. And all of these screens you are looking at right now are providing these teams with real-time information about what's happening on the fire ground. So the first screen you can see there, that's a map of New South Wales with a little orange section. That indicates extreme fire danger. If we move along, you can see, of course, they are actively monitoring what's happening with the weather. And as I mentioned earlier, we have seen some scattered showers throughout the central west of New South Wales. Good news, but not quite enough to really make a huge difference when it comes to those two emergency bushfire warnings that we saw yesterday. And then, of course, here, Sarah, this is the main screen. You can see those white, yellow and one orange triangle. That indicates all of the active fires that are right now burning throughout New South Wales. As I say, two emergency bushfire warnings declared yesterday. Good news, some reprieved conditions mean those have been downgraded, but there is one in particular that they are still focusing on. That is the one towards Bathurst. Here was the RFS with more detail about that fire.
Where these fires are burning around at the Alpha Road fire and others up near Wellington and Dubbo, we're still going to see 30, 40 kilometre an hour westerly winds, really warm temperatures and very dry. So again, a few uncontained fires, bad conditions. It is a day that, again, we'll see firefighters really challenged.
So, Sarah, in less than an hour's time, the aerial tanks will once again be flying above the fire ground, and fire crews on the ground, they have been actively trying to protect properties, in particular around the Dubbo area and also the Bathurst area overnight. As for Sydneysiders, strap yourself in for another sticky and sweltering day. 36 degrees out west, 34 for the CBD.
Another hot one. Thank you, Lara.